Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss with you about online classes. Nowadays there are many schools and many teachers who are organizing online classes. So here are some tips I am sharing with you on the basis of my experience. So first see what is online classes. So friends, online classes mean the interaction between the students and teacher based on internet. So when there is a interaction between student and teacher by using any internet service is called online classes. Now what are the requirements of the online classes? So here are some requirements of the online classes. The student, teachers and computers, we can say a smartphone, and some online classes softwares like Skype, Zoom, etc., etc., and a good internet connectivity. Because it is since a video conferencing, so you need to have a proper internet connectivity. Otherwise, the conference will not be possible. So you need to take care of the even the internet speed of the all the devices, like students and teachers. Everyone's internet connectivity should be good for this internet online classes. Now what preparation should be done before conducting the online classes? You should be prepare yourself as a teacher. So you should prepare all the teaching learning materials which are required for online classes, like PowerPoint presentation, ebooks, images, video, diagram, whatever you want to show during the online classes. Prepare it well before the classes itself. So whenever you want to use it during your online classes, let it open with you. Keep it ready to be used during the online classes. Plan all the activities, like plan properly with all the lesson plans that generally you do, and also think about the evaluation strategies, because finally you have to evaluate the student's learning. That's why it is also should be decided before the classes begin. So that you should take keep in your mind when you are taking any online class. Now whenever possible, plan your online class 1 or 2 days before, so everyone will be available on that period, on that particular time. Keep the password for the meeting, that is useful to keep the privacy of the class, and also share the details about that, about your planning, about the timing and everything about the class by using SMS or WhatsApp group or some personal chatting tools. So do not share these invitations on social media, because it can be viral, it can be go to anyone else. So better to share it on the personal chat. Make sure that if in case of parents, in case of minor students who are under 18 age, you have taken the consent of the parent that they will participate in the online class. Then when students are sitting, you need to take care whether they are sitting properly with the light on face position, so their faces can be clear visible to everyone. So tell them to avoid the backlights positions, like open window or sitting somewhere outside, so lots of noise comes. Also tell them to make proper arrangement of the microphone and speakers and earphone. Better to take the test of it, so everyone will be audible and visible. Also inform students not to freeze all the activity behind. Okay, sometimes some family members comes and disturb, like kids or someone else, and that create the distraction in the class. So it should be clearly instructed to the students and their parents that during the class all the activities at the background of the students should be stopped. Tell student to take the notes during the class. It is not only enjoyment. They should sit with the pen and paper and pencil, so notebooks and books, so they will be ready for taking the notes. keep some instruction with you written on page. So in case of someone mind's mic is not working, you can show that particular instruction so they can even read it, and that is even good for the students who are some problems with the hearing. When you are starting with the class, wait for everyone to join, because you know it may take 5 minutes or 5 to 6 minutes, 10 minutes sometimes, that all maximum students can join. Unless maximum students join the classes, you can start with some informal discussion with the students. Students who have joined already, you can tell them to check their audio and video devices, so you can just have informal chat during the waiting period. There are chatting facility in almost all chat online classes softwares. You also inform them. Some messages can be given during the conferencing itself. Also inform them about various facilities, icons available in that particular online class window, so they will be familiar with that. Before class begin, you can start with the greeting as usual, your traditional class. You also check their microphone and camera. Brief them initially about the classes activities. Tell them the plan of the overall class, so they will aware about it. Also inform them about your plan B in case of electricity failure or some technical issues. Also share with them do's and don'ts, so they will be doing accordingly. And also when you are sharing resources, consider students' variety of internet speed. So I would like to suggest that do not use any videos during the online classes, because it's very difficult to stream the video in video conferencing itself, because there are lots of data issues around connectivity. Involve all the students in the classroom. It should not be teacher centered class. You should ask some question to the students, so it should be interactive. Let them express, let them ask the question, let them ask the queries, and in that way it should be two-way communication. You also, when you are observing them, also observe their body language, so that is even the kind of indication to you. Also remember, the classroom atmosphere should be free, so student can express their queries and ask their doubts. You can do two kind of evaluation, one during the class itself by asking some oral question, and when you are ending with the class, in that period also you can ask some questions to them, so you will come whether they understood or not. Also give some assignments to the students, and also provides them some online more resources, so they will be able to get the more information about the topic that they have learned in that particular online class. The share digital resources like presentations, PDF files, web links, and some other platforms like WhatsApp, Google Classroom, and email, website, etc., etc. So they should be having additional information about some learning materials. Also, there should be some online assessment which can be conducted later on, and it should be informed to the students that there will be some online offline assessment of the basis on the content that they learnt in the online class. During the time of the period, they should understand that this is not purely entertainment, but it's also edutainment. So they should treat the online classes seriously. It's not fun, it's for learning purpose, so it should be conducted seriously. For that purpose, it should be very interactive. And as a teacher, you should consider some of the technical issues that can be interfere the learning, so you should bear with it. and do not conduct it regularly so the other students can feel left out. Very important, read the all data and privacy policy of the online meeting app that you are using. You also aware about the risk and the privacy threats of that app, and you also discuss with this topic to the students, and you also inform to the parents that what are the privacy and data policy of the app that they are using. Now there are some limitation to this online classes. Yes, all the student not having the internet facilities or all the requirements of the online class in that case. So this should be some alternative provide, something should be provided to the students who do not have such kind of facilities. And when number of students are more, it's very difficult to interact with each and everyone. And one more limitation, that we cannot have the this type of classroom for all the topics. So dear teachers, you are using it, use it as an alternative to the traditional classroom. In case of it's not like that you are using this online classes only in lockdown period or when you are working from home, but even you can use it in your regular classroom activities when regularly the school is functioning. So thank you very much for your patience hearing.